bust. So they boo each other, think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break a bone, me and myself top two. I blow away the competition like a bowl of hot soup. And there's no catch, I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB, I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 in the karma dash. I shake a pick, told them all, you went first, you last. Little boy, that's facts, I'ma grow that cash to my money.
They don't know my name, I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
This is the NFL on EA Sports, and we are in the Pacific Northwest at Lumen Field in Seattle, Washington. This crowd, as we've come to expect in recent years, as loud as any in the NFL, and they get even louder when their Seahawks are introduced. We're ready for football as the Seahawks get set to do battle with the Los Angeles Rams. Here's the kicker, Jason Myers, to get this one started. And off we go from Seattle. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. A dream chance for any D lineman to possibly get a pick, but instead it falls down incomplete
at the 25-yard line.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. The gun. Here's Goff. Trying to find Kupp, but it's intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And it's a tremendous return as they finally get him at about the 10-yard line. I'm not sure that you can say that the rain caused that interception, but look, it's clear that throwing the football is going to be tough in these conditions.
No doubt about it, and different quarterbacks handle it different ways. Some guys think the rain isn't a big deal, but wind affects them a little bit more. But you have to wonder, will these conditions hold scoring down? Are we going to have like a 9-6 type of a game? And then the pressure goes on the punters, who often hold for field goal attempts. Can they handle the snap and get the ball down so they can kick it?
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. After the interception, here's Wilson. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll make this a second down.
Second and 2 at the Rams' 3-yard line.
No. Tech 50, Tech 50.
They get this out left, and he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down.
He's up 3rd and 4.
This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down.
Jason Myers on for the field goal. A 22.
And Myers able to knock it through. And the Seahawks grab a 3-0 lead. Weather like this, always treacherous for kickers. A good sign early, though, is he's able to put that one through.
And you remember him right before the kick, stomping around his area to...
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so it shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick, look, I know defensive backs, they have a tendency to be a little bit...
into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
Intercepted.
First quarter, and now he already has two interceptions.
Yeah, he's got to guard against being tentative from this point forward, though. He's got to still make the right reads, make the proper throws. I've seen guys in this league throw 4 interceptions in a game and win. He's got to understand, put it behind you, keep pressing forward.
Wilson, after the play fake to Carson, steps away. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. 23 yards on the play.
First and goal at the 6-yard line.
To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scout. Scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage.
With another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now.
Big stop, dude. Big stop. Let's go.
This is Carson. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to set up a 3rd and goal.
And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes 3rd and goal. Here's a quick throw out left. It's complete. A terrific job there to keep him out of the end zone. And now it'll be 4th and goal.
No gain on the play. Brings up 4th and goal.
They run for it with Carson. And I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. They stop him up short on 4th and goal from the 1. And it's Rams defense comes up with a goal line stand. set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And really, they're pretty fortunate right now to only be down 3-0 following two turnovers. They've got it now first and 10. That's into the hands of Akers, complete. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll be second down.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up second and 5 at the 7-yard line.
Now the first carry for Cam Akers. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9-yard line. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3.
It's a gain of 2 yards. And it's 3rd down.
A shotgun snap for Goff. Man open, it's Kupp, he's got it. And he is going to have a Rams first down, and he's going to have it by plenty. Able to get 8 yards there on 3rd and 2. A Ram first down as Goff finds Kupp. On the carry there, it'll be 2nd down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Here's a run with Akers on 2nd down. And he'll take this one up to about the 23.
Akers again, the ball carrier.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Goff now to throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on 4th and 10.
And it's 4th down.
They are going for it. Goff. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 26. And he'll be down at the 6-yard line. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports.
Seahawks 3, Rams nothing.
Suddenly, it's 1st and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. From the shotgun, Wilson. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
Partner, this is almost an unwinnable spot for a defense. They have to come right out for a 1st and goal trying to stop them. But let me hold on a second. Let me take that back real quick. They can win here if they force a field goal try. Still a long ways away from that happening, but that has to be what they're thinking right now.
And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out. And yes, they want the points, so they will decline the penalty, no question there.
You don't think they spent a couple seconds mulling over what the penalty would
do? I don't even know why they asked the sideline.
Not at all. When you put the ball in the end zone on a takeaway, take the points and keep moving.
Footing always a concern, but the extra points up and good, and the lead grows to 10-0. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And this carries into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Goff will lead the Rams up here 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll throw from the gun. He'll throw complete to Cam Akers.
And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
A gain of 12. And the Rams first down.
They'll run out of the gun with Akers.
And a six-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
Cam Akers.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
On second down and four, Goff. He wants Reynolds way downfield.
Got a man, it's caught at the six-yard line. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown Rams. Josh Reynolds, 57 yards. And the Rams are able to get back within a touchdown. Oh, he missed it. No good. So this remains a four-point game.
Matt Gay set to kick off.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. This is DJ Reed returning. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Russell Wilson.
No doubt that's a very good play defensively right there, because you've always got to be aware that he can take off and make a big play with his legs. How about the way they were able to contain him? That also tells me the coverage was excellent downfield.
They'll come up after the sack on a second and 12. Now Carlos Hyde in the game. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 15 yards on the play, first down. Good push up front, and then a run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
Here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
At the 50 yard line.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. On first down, they go screen pass to Hyde. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
Seahawks, first and goal at the 7-yard line.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Here's Carson, and he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Brings up second.
They run the counter. Carson, and he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. And they drew up the counter there. It worked. They're glad they drew up the counter.
And a lot of times when what you're trying to do is just simply get the defense moving in one direction. It doesn't take much, even one step's enough. Get them going in one direction and then cut back against the grain and let your running back finish it off and get the work done.
And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21.
The Rams take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And this not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness, maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
Looking to throw again on second down. Goff. That's into the hands of Reynolds. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 7 yards there and a first down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
On first and 10, gone. Now that'll be caught by Kupp. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Second quarter action, 1:56 remaining. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and 4. Of 11.
And it's third down.
Third and long. It's gone.
And 15.
And yet again, Goff is intercepted.
Shaquille Don't worry Griffin about it, people. Don't worry about it. Let's go.
And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about, getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right, a lost opportunity.
After the interception, here's Goff. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Out of the gun, gone. A quick pass to Kupp. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 15 yards on the play. First down.
15. First down, Rams.
Goff. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. He's picked off just shy of midfield, and he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. Well, this is just crazy. He's got three interceptions, Charles, and we haven't even departed the first half of this ballgame.
I think if you're looking at the stats right now, you're saying, all right, who's the leading receiver? Well, can you flip it around and say that maybe he is and could be for the game the way that things are going right now? I think if it's him, he wants to be on the field at all times.
Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line.
And Brandon, the passing game for both of these teams is going to be affected as the game goes along. It's not looking like the rain's going to let up anytime soon, so that might mean a few more wobbly passes and wide receiver slips, and this one winds up getting intercepted.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go. He was looking for Cooper Kupp there, and it's second down. To throw is gone. Escaping the pressure right. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
On the throwaway. It's third down and 10.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Goodness, another interception picked off by DJ Reed.
DJ Reed. Goff's pass intercepted. The Seahawks take over first and 10 at the 21-yard line.
So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. He hit his first, this one from 38. Myers' kick is good. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. Here's Reed returning. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Play action. Now Wilson. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
As defensive coordinators around the league tell me all the time, that throw is not for every quarterback because you've really got to drive the ball downfield. It's going to be a tight window for him to fit that one into. In this case, unsuccessfully.
On third down, it's Carson. And this play going to be stopped in its tracks at the 32 and obviously well short of the first down. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down. Now here's Michael Dixon. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. Webster now to return. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10.
19-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And Charles, they trail by a couple of scores, but if they could put a good drive together here, it'd go a long way toward getting them back in this football game.
And if you're looking at a checklist of things that they need to do in the second half, job number one was getting a stop, wasn't it? So big check right there. Now they want to see if their offense can build on that momentum.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Second and two.
What?
Going right back to Akers. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Down. They'll get this to Akers out of the backfield. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First down, Los Angeles there with a pickup of 14 yards. From the gun, here's Goff. Got a man open, it's Tyler Higbee. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1.
At the 47-yard line.
Goff now looking to throw. He'll get this one to Kupp, complete. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Los Angeles.
Again, Goff. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Shaquille Griffin knocking it away that time in coverage.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
We sit in quarter number 3 out in Seattle. A 2nd and 10 now. From the shotgun, here's a give to Akers. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially nothing on that one, no gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on 3rd down.
3rd down.
A shotgun snap for Goff. And open, it's Kupp. He's got it. And he is going to have a Rams 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
A gain of 12.
12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another 1st down. On the ground, it's Akers. And he'll go down at the 28.
Cam Akers.
Give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the 3rd quarter. No time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
They'll come out in a 4-receiver look. 3 men to the right side on 2nd and 6. Now gone, looking for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Trey Flowers picks it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The number 7, usually lucky here, not for him. 7 picks he's thrown in this game. That's only happened 6 times since 1960.
And I know that the most recent time it happened, the guy who threw him, he won a Heisman Trophy in college. So sometimes you just have a lousy game. Doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad career. But when you're talking about 1 game, 7, you're right, not lucky at all.
Yeah, Ty Detmer, the last to do it in 2001 to throw 7 picks. Wilson, after the play fake to Carson. Rolling to his right. He lets it fly from... That's caught inside the 20. And on the way in, touchdown Seattle. Tyler Lockett.
66 yards. And the Seahawks add on to their lead.
Jason Myers.
All the talk when Russell Wilson came into the league about his hot. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. This will be caught at about the six. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more. And that's something you almost never see nowadays. When you fake it, you're at the 15-yard line on a PAT as opposed to just going for it from the two.
I'm sorry. I know they got it, and congratulations to them, but it's just not a good play. I mean, the risk-reward is really off the charts. Not in your favor. Run your offense out there. Put it on the 2-yard line if you want to go for two. But I'll be darned. They ended up getting that one, didn't they?
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
It's a gain of 17.
17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. On first down, gone. That's into the hands of Akers, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Goff on first down. Over the middle, that's hauled in by Kupp. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. They'll run on first down with Akers. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. In on the stop, it was the UCF product, Shaquem Griffin. The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. Back to throw. Goff eluding the pressure right. And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 17. And give him now 4 interceptions in this game. That's only the third time this has been done since the year 2000.
I think that tells you how much better teams have gotten at throwing the football. Because if you go all the way back to 1960, 12 times before that, there have been guys who've gotten 4 interceptions or more in a game. I mean, most recently since 2000, Delta O'Neal and D'Angelo Hall.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll make it second down.
Brings up second and
now it's Carson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 15 yards on the play, first down. Another example of this offense really having their way, Charles, and another big chunk play there on the ground.
And when you look at the defense, they've got to do a much better job of wrapping up when they tackle. A lot of great opportunities continue to slip through their fingers, as do the runners.
He'll run it. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Play action. It's Wilson. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. And all the way in. Touchdown, Seattle. David Moore, 35 yards. Yeah, the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. He gets it to go, and the lead swells, 35-6.
Seahawks 35, Rams 6.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in a good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
Yeah, turn the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. Well, just another reason to celebrate there on the defensive side with the interception, and this is a game that they clearly have firmly in their grasp.
Yeah, a lot of handshakes, a lot of hugs, a lot of smiles. It's been their day.
After the interception, here's Wilson. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And this one is incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf. That'll bring up second down.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
On second down, it's Carson. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. The Seahawks on third down. 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and four.
Makes it third and
going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
And that one will be no good. He never had it online. It's well wide to the left. And this score will stay right where it is.
Now, if this was a clear day in September, I'd say this is well within his range. I'd feel very confident about this kick. But let's be honest about it. In these elements, the difficulty level gets ratcheted up by at least a factor of five.
And now here is another interception. Trey Flowers picks it, and his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the...
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by John Johnson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now they get a fourth quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other.
but it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over.
A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
At the 4-yard line.
Goff now to throw. That's into the hands of Reynolds. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
First down, Los Angeles.
Now Goff. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down. The Rams on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 10. To the air again, Goff. Airing it out deep for Woods. And that will be incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. Returning it is Moore. A big boot that time. 57 yards the official distance. And we have reached the 2-minute warning.
26-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. We've got a lopsided game here. I don't know, Charles, what does the handbook say that we discuss when we've got a game like this in the fourth quarter?
Hold a second. Let me thumb to the proper page on that. Know what it says?
What?
Let's discuss how we got here. This is a dominant performance, where they took control of this game, how they've managed to keep control of this game, and then we go ahead and think about how we're going to leave here and get to the airport. In a lopsided blowout, the roads are usually open.
So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down. Just gets rid of it, throws it away. The wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down. They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progression. And here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield. He was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. And down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense. Marching in for the sack, Michael Brockers. They were trying to set up that screen, trying to get that screen to formulate. Took too long.
He ends up taking a sack, and that leads you to a couple of other questions. Number one, why don't you just get rid of
it? And how about this? A fake. And this is caught, but he will not make the first down marker. That'll be a turnover on downs. It'll be a pickup of 12 yards. Then the Rams get the football in outstanding field position. Now a first down throw. Gone. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
Yeah, once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. And this now 3rd and 11 after that second down completion actually went back a yard. Out of the gun, Goff.
This pass complete to Reynolds. And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That third down conversion, good for 23. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. One last throw here for Goff. And this is going to be intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And that will write a finish to this ball game.
Today's final score.
So the victory here for Seattle. And they were really helped by their defense, forcing three turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of... But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had three takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. It's a win for the Seahawks here as we say so long from Seattle.